Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to St. Joseph for Mass today. For announcements, basically in the bulletin in my little article, I mentioned a little thing about the Knights of Columbus having an online meeting. So if you're interested, then please contact Michael Borman, I believe, and he will set you up for that. But it's all about retiring and how we can live happily in retirement. So if you're interested, please contact Mike in the that's in the bulletin. Believe me, I am so thankful for the sunshine. It's been like a week of depression, a week of down in the dumps, cold and stuff like that. Even the children at school, they were just itching to get outside, but they couldn't. So I'm so thankful that we have some sunshine this week, and that we're able to finally enjoy the weather. So, on this day, let us stand and let us greet our neighbor.
Let us pray.
upon us, O Lord, O God, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Asked him, Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive? As many as seven times? Jesus answered, I say to you, not seven times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle his accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property, in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down and did homage and said, Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full. Moved with compassion, the master of the servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, Pay back what you owe. Falling to his knees, his fellow servants begged him, Be patient with me, and I will pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now his fellow servants saw that what had happened. They were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, You wicked servant, I forgave your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you? Then in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you, unless each of you forgive your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Friday was an important day in America. We celebrated 9/11, and I mentioned in my homily for the children at the school mass that day how I was in middle school when all this happened. And I still remember being told, the teachers themselves not fully understanding what was happening. We turned on the television and just watched throughout the day. I think we got out of school a couple hours early that day, too. And it took me about a full year to comprehend what had happened that day. And I still think, even to this day, that I'm still struggling to comprehend why someone could do something so evil. And there have been so many tributes and memorials and remembrances since that day. It's difficult to capture what this anniversary, what it means to us as Americans. Things we feel, they're almost beyond words. We're still in so many ways, still groping in the dark, struggling to find a way to deal with all that has changed in America. Yet, this day, as we come before the altar of God with our prayers and petitions, we hear these words from the ancient prophet in our first reading. Forgive your neighbor's injustice. Then when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. In the gospel, Jesus says again, forgive your brother in your heart. But how do we do this? I wish I knew. I wish I could give you an answer. I wish there was some sort of switch you need to switch on your heart. That would be a forgiveness switch. I wish I knew how to love all of my enemies and to pray for all of my persecutors and to forgive my neighbor's injustices, even the most heinous injustice of all. Though I think that perhaps forgiveness, like conversion, it's a journey. The human heart isn't necessarily converted overnight. We don't all have that electrifying moment like St. Paul had on the road to Damascus, where he was converted almost instantly. For most of us, this conversion, it grows in what Flannery O'Connor calls a habit of being. It happens over a lifetime. Conversion is a daily choice. It's something we have to think about again and again. There is no graduating from it. There is no perfecting it. And so is love. And so I believe is forgiveness. Like all the challenges of our faith, it's something we need to pray for. To pray to be able to do what we're called to do as Christians. To love our neighbor. To love our enemies. To forgive our neighbors from justice. And C.S. Lewis put it beautifully when he said, to be a Christian is to forgive the inexcusable. Because God has first forgiven us. A couple weeks ago, we heard Christ tell his disciples, take up your cross and follow me. But one of the heaviest crosses we have to bear as Christians is the call to forgive. Even when something seems unforgivable, especially then. By God's grace, as Christians, and by Christ's example, somehow we pick up that cross, following after Christ. We bear it on our backs when we begin this long walk. And we may carry it on our backs, bearing the brunt and bearing the weight of all that this entails. But what's more important is what we hold in our hearts. And it is this, that love is greater than hate, that hope is stronger than despair, that vengeance is no match for forgiveness. And this Sunday, we pray to remember that. We pray very simply in remembrance. Remember all the lives that were lost, the martyrs who were born, the heroes who did what no one thought was possible. We remember. We remember courage. And we remember sacrifice.
Church will lead the way in calling for fairness and resolving conflict. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations locked in disagreement break the ancient bond of hatred and seek always to settle differences without force of violence. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick in our parish community, that they might receive the physical care they need and take comfort in Jesus' healing power. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they find a ready welcome in God's heavenly kingdom. For Jim and Terry Birkin, and for Ben and Marie and Father Van Aa, let us pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May this faith community witness God's unconditional love by being a place of compassion to anyone seeking encouragement, acceptance, and reconciliation. We pray to the Lord. For the prayers and needs that each of us hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, open up our hearts to your loving will, granting all of our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these your servants' offerings, that what each is offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son, you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Just as a reminder for communion today, that the church is in four sections, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and we do sections 1 and 3 at the same time, we rotate this way, and then we do sections 2 and 4, rotating this way.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
healed.
working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects, and not our own desires, may always prevail in us, through Christ our Lord. I wish you a very beautiful week, and please do enjoy the warm weather and the sun. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth proclaiming the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.